Yogic pranams to all of you.
So mantra japa has to help you in disciplining. In that disciplining, what happens, you know, when you start disciplining yourself, all dimensions of your being, they start moving towards a center. Centripetal movement takes place. Now it is centrifugal. Body says, sit. Mind says, no, I am not interested. Intellect says, what is logic in meditating? Om Namah Shivaya every day, lousy thing, because it is intellect. Social being says, you have many things to attend, why are you wasting your time? You take any activity in your life, find out whether all dimensions of your personality are saying yes to that activity, any activity. You have physical being, you have emotional being, you have breathing being, your psychological being, intellectual being, so many beings are with you. Each one is like a limited company. Limited company. Many have invested. Society has invested. Divinity has invested. That's why we call it Pitru Runa, Deva Runa, Samaj Runa. So many Runa we have. Because so many have invested in creating this jiva. Don't think that you are free. So many factors are involved in making. Just imagine your making. For example, you are a graduate. You know how many people, how much effort, how much resources have put in making you a graduate? Just imagine how many people are working for you while studying in the college. So many lecturers, principal, investment, books. So you need books. So many people are working for books. And then you have to go to the college, the vehicles, transport. My God, when you start thinking, I have to be grateful to so many things. So that's why in India we have developed this psyche of worshipping the plant, the stone, this, that, everything. It is not a foolish thing. There is sense behind the whole thing because you are in touch with everything. So when you start disciplining yourself, all these beings, turn towards that center. When they turn towards that center, then the energy starts confluencing in that center. All your social energy, emotional energy, all they start moving into that space. So, then you are gathering all the energies. When you start gathering all the energies, automatically you become a very strong, healthy human being. So for that you need a center. That is what the initiation is. When a spiritual master initiates, it means he has created a process where all the beings start looking towards that center. So you start gathering that energy. When you start gathering that energy, you confront with many blocks, many hurdles, many problems, so many things. Then by strengthening this center, you slowly diffuse those difficulties. So these difficulties slowly disappear, and then you are free from all the difficulties. When you become free from all the difficulties, then you discipline the activity. Otherwise, how can you be free from the problem? So freedom from the problem means disciplining. When you discipline, you can become free. Are you seeing it? Are we all together? Then another interesting thing about the mantra is, you are all initiated by a single Guru Parampara. Now, your mind is gathering energy and composing and bringing all the dimensions together to a particular center. And all these centers are connected to a higher center. Please see this. Higher center. So, collectively, the energy band expands. That is the beauty. You are all connected to a particular parampara means that much distance. So when you get into any problem, immediately hundreds of people there to support you at that time. Hundreds of people, because the parampara, we all belong to the same group. So immediately rush, help. So help is given. So you become the part of that whole. You become the part of that whole. That develops when you start meditating like this. So friends, you are initiated into that, the majestic, powerful network of freedom. Now, how you are going to strengthen yourself as a strong member is your responsibility. So you can do it in 3-4 ways. The first one is Anushthana Krama. You have to practice regularly. Regularly means same time, in the same way. And when you start doing in the same way, if there is excitement, you are still a weakling. If there is boredom, you are still a weak fellow. So both excitement and boredom are not the virtues of a disciplined life. Are you seeing it? Both excitement and boredom, they are the two sides of the same coin. From this side it is boredom, from this side it is excitement. If you say Guruji, chanting the same mantra again and again is boring, it means ashrita, you are depending upon that. You are asking some sensation from that. It means still you are a parasite. Oh, I am getting excited. Still you are a parasite. Both excitement and boredom are the signs of dependency. So when the boredom sets in, the mind says change it, so we change. So hopping from one sensation to another sensation. If you are after sensations, You are not an integrated human being. So the mind creates such kind of restless waves. So whether it is boredom or excitement, I am going to continue. So by continuing, what happens psychologically? You are freeing yourself from boredom and also from excitement. So when there is no boredom and there is no excitement, then there is samatva. In that samatva only your intelligence operates, the wisdom operates. Wisdom will not operate when you are bored. Wisdom will not operate when you are excited. Are you seeing the complicated, it's a beautiful thing. I want you to study all these things. I want you to share all these things with me. Guruji, please, you keep quiet. We will share. You know, this is what's happening. This is what's happening. This is what's happening. Give me that excitement. There should not be any excitement, but give me that excitement. Give me that excitement. Are you seeing it? So this is what Gurudev says, meditation introduces you to your own self, and meditation gives everything. It's going to give you everything, I'm telling you.